There's three fundamental laws of the universe. I call them these in particular. You can call them whatever you want. Doesn't matter the title, as long as it has the same substance, you know? Same shit, different flies, right? First law is the law of abundance. What's the opposite law of abundance? That would be scarcity. The second law is the law of balance. The opposite of balance would be chaos. The third law is the law of cooperation. Opposite of cooperation would be competition. So, the first law, abundance. What does that mean? It means that there is enough love to go around. That's basically where it comes from, the concept of love. Like, there's no limit to how much love you can give somebody, right? It's just your choice. It's always there in your heart. Either you choose to give it and be kind to people, unkind to your children, or you don't, right? It's like a bank account with unlimited funds. It's funny because the whole concept of money comes from this concept of love, which love is based on the element of water, which is Uniform Commercial Code, Maritime Admiralty Law, okay? But it is a kind of inversion of that. Your soul is your unlimited bank account. The second law is the law of balance. What's the opposite of balance? Chaos. This simply means that there is law and order and a straight line in which everything else judges and balances itself from. Like a sine wave or a vortex or, you know, like the spinning tornado, like the Fibonacci sequence, if you know that spin. This is also the concept of sin. Sin would be chaos, meaning going against the tides, going against the natural order and harmony to things. The third law is a law of cooperation. This is basically, if you imagine it, God and Satan. Take, for example, even if you don't believe in this concept, God's kingdom is light, meaning everybody can see everything. So we all know what we're doing. We're all on the same page, cooperating together, working together for mutual benefit. The whole is greater than the sum of its parts. The opposite would be Satan's kingdom, which would be darkness, competition, compartmentalization. Nobody can see anything. You need a clearance, like the CIA and top secret organizations. Everything is compartmentalized to hide. The right hand doesn't know what the left hand's doing, right? So that way, there's no, it's always like a game to see who has and maintains power. It's always a power struggle, competition. One winner, one loser. One person has to take, and that means somebody's got to lose. That's what competition is. However, competition and games are always played on a field, which there is rules that you have to follow. So competition isn't the foundation of that game being played. It's always going to be cooperation, meaning this is the field. If you go out of bounds, you know, there's certain rules to like a soccer field or hockey, like all these games where there's one team that wins, one that loses. So this is what I came to understand. This is also the Holy Trinity, if you think about it. There's just three fundamental laws. Now, where do human beings fit into all this? Here's where you fit and I fit into this. We have something called free will. What is free will? Free will is freedom to choose what you want. That's what you have. Nobody can force you to do anything. I'm not talking physically. I'm talking make you believe anything. You cannot. This is a natural law. I'm not going to get into an argument, but you cannot really prove anything to anyone. This is why in court, you have to be judged by a jury of your peers. Even if they have a videotape, let's say of a murder trial, of somebody killing somebody, see, he's right there. If those jurors say, nope, I still don't believe it, it don't matter if you can demonstrate it or not. They have to choose that, yes, that is what he did. It's called the burden of proof for a reason. Just like you can lead a horse to water, you can't make him drink. You can't prove anything to anybody. Sometimes we get frustrated when we find truth about something. We try to show somebody it, and they're just like, no, I don't believe that. It's like, well, look, I'm showing to you. It's like, I don't care. I don't believe in that stuff. It's not real. Even if you were to, I just don't want to. That's free will. It's all choice. This is all how the concept of vampires, that whole concept of a vampire needing permission to enter your home, comes from this law. This law is what we were given as human beings, above the animals and the plants and everything. Because animals don't have free will. We're special because we have freedom. We can do whatever we want. Can't choose the consequences, but we can choose whatever we want to do. Animals, they do what they do. A pig is a pig. A duck's a duck. You know, You dress him up like a pig, he's still going to be a freaking duck. You know what I'm saying? So animals don't have that. That's the difference between us and them. Okay? The difference is we have a soul. The soul, if you imagine it, try to imagine it like water. Okay? Water is what our bodies are mostly made up of. Okay? It's the most abundant element. Water's magnetic, too. It has two basic atomic structures in it. It's got one proton, one electron. Proton is simply saying like pro, like positive or masculine. Electron is like negative or like Adam and Eve, okay? Two, like kind of like binary code. Ones and zeros on a magnet, which is magnets have on a hard drive, they get read by ones or zeros, all right? This is why water has a magnetic property to it. Water pulls into itself. It coheses together. The spirit, which houses the soul, is, if you can imagine or think of fire, how fire works. Fire moves and pushes you away. We run away from fire, but we run towards water, right? Because in the summertime, you see by the beaches, everybody just flocking towards the beaches. That's the spiritual concept of water, because it's magnetic, it's pulling you. On your body, front of your body is where the water and or soul feeling centers are, the front. The back is the spiritual centers, the fire. Okay, so the fire on your back is pushing you, water in the front's pulling you. You're only going one way, and that is always forward. This is where the whole concept of contracts comes into play. Contracts, or signing that line, has to do with free will and choosing. When you're signing that line, you're saying, I agree and accept this. And here is the documented memorialization of my choice. Okay? That's all contracts come from. They come from the spiritual law. Okay? So, here we go with the spiritual body, which is the house for the soul. The soul is here to grow and expand. Okay, and as you grow the soul, it gets bigger and bigger. And that's what we're here to do, is to expand our soul, which is where we get all of our love from, all of our heart and our feelings and what makes us human beings come from. Our lives are always the ultimate superior factor that determines how our lives are lived, or where we end up, or where we are now, is our choice. We hear this whole thing of nurture versus nature. That's ridiculous. That's just meant to confuse you. Your conditions and your environment do influence you, and they do have a power of influence. But ultimately, it is your choices that reign superior, and that is the authority of what determines how you end up. So it's all choice. Okay? Choice is free will. Free will is love, it's freedom. That is the power human beings have and possess. That's what makes us special. Learning skills and acquiring disciplines, everything is a skill. Praying, for example. A lot of us don't even know how to pray. Simple thing you think about. And, you know, just bear with me for all you people that, you know, are anti-God, there's no God and all that crap. Just listen to the concept I'm going to explain to you. You know, a lot of people say, you read the Bible and they tell you, oh, you got to pray like this. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, and all this stuff. It's like, look, let me tell you something. You don't talk to God like he's some kind of president. If you think about it, if, let's say there was a God, just for example, and he loves us no matter what, right? And he gave us free will. That means that he's your best friend. And he responds to you better when you talk to him from your heart and who you really are. Like, you know, you talk to yourself, you think you're talking to yourself, you're like, I got to remember to do this, and, you know, that guy did this, and I'm really hurt, and this guy upset me, and those voices going on your head. Well, that's just a natural way for you to communicate with God. And that's why children naturally do that. A lot of them end up making these invisible friends, you know, that they make up because, you know, parents hear them talking to somebody, they think they're crazy. It's a joke. Roses are red, violets are blue. I'm a schizophrenic, and so am I. Everyone's afraid that if they get caught talking to themselves, then they're crazy. No, you're not really talking to yourself, man. You're talking to God. It's what you want to do. It's just, when you don't believe there is a God, it's kind of like you're choosing to block. It's like you're almost sabotaging yourself. Listen to me. Don't ever promise anything to God. Like, I swear I'll do this. For those of us who've had hangovers, please, God, if you make me stop feeling like this, I swear I'll never drink again. You don't swear to God because you're always going to break your promises. You don't swear to God because you're upsetting him. It's just, dude, you're just hurting yourself. You're always going to break your promise to him. So why are you going to promise him anything? Say, look, God, please do this for me. I really need this. Ask. That's all you got to do. You'll be surprised on what happens. So that's just a skill. Everything is a skill. Just like riding a bike. A skill is like building a house, an invisible house. When you learn how to ride a bike, you have built a little, like, little building called riding a bike. And then you learn how to read, and you built a little internalized building, you know, like an invisible building inside you that houses that skill. Like the carpenter, all right? These are skills. Skills is a discipline. Discipline is acquiring something after growing with it and learning it. So you're building something internally, which, you know, is not physical. There's no limit. So I have a little buildings that are guitar and banjo and reading and writing and dad and learning to do this and that. That's what building disciplines is, like a disciple or like steeple, like some, you know, some kind of building. And everything that you do is a skill, but you have to practice and use it, just like riding a bike. So praying really isn't that complicated, and you don't have to listen to anybody tell you how to do it. In my opinion, you talk to God like he's your best friend. He knows everything about you if you think about it. I mean, if you believe in God, he knows everything about you. He knows what you're gonna do. You know, don't lie to him. You're not lying to him. You're just lying to yourself, and you're kind of sabotaging that message from hitting him. Because God is just, and he appreciates honesty, talking from the heart. You know, like a lot of Christians, you know, a lot of people that are religious, they put on this facade when they talk about, oh, Jesus is so great. I just love Jesus. He wants you to be happy and wealthy and rich. These guys don't talk like that when they're home with their wives. Hey, honey, when's the chicken gonna be done? I'm so hungry. Yeah, Jesus. I mean, nobody talks like that. Be real. Come from the heart. Be yourself, man. That's what I learned. I'm just sharing with you the other day. I was talking to God, like, it was like one of the best conversations I've ever had. And it was really incredible. And I almost felt like he was talking to me. Talking back. At least I thought he was. I mean, might be somebody else in there talking. But you know, if you're asking honestly, you'll receive. Remember, if you're not good at something, don't worry. It takes time. It's a skill. You got to develop it. Peace.